You're an Olympian, a Commonwealth medalist, a World Cup winner. What can't you do?
Hit a penalty earlier, I was shocking at it. Can't hit a ball in the back of a net to save my life.
At least you are human then. That's good. That's great to have it confirmed. There are some things that you struggle at. And actually, it's amazing that you've gone on to achieve everything that you have done in rugby, considering for a while it looked like you were going to be a netballer, am I right?
Yeah. So netball was my main sport till I was about 18. Mm-hmm. Played a little bit of rugby beforehand at Dryburgh Rugby Club, like local place with my sisters. But I just loved netball. I played probably 3-4 times a week. Poor mum and dad running me around, but it never really took off for me. I never really got past like England trials, and it was always something that I wanted to do. I wanted to represent my country, so I kind of turned my hand to something different and never looked back.
And where on the court did you play back when you played?
Centre court. Well, I used to shoot until I got told I was too short to shoot. Mm-hmm. And then I moved into like centre court, so like wing attack, wing defence centre.
Too short to shoot, ends up as a scrum half. Yeah, sounds about right. And actually, all that centre court play must have been incredible conditioning prep for rugby, because you've got to be so fit for netball.
Oh yeah, for sure. Like, I think I probably was at my fittest when I was playing netball, which I'm sure my S&C probably won't appreciate.
Don't say that on record.
Yeah, no, but it's true. Like, because obviously all of the change of direction, like the D-cell, XL, and obviously training like 3-4 times a week and then playing matches on top. Some weeks we'd train that much and then have 2 matches as well. So it was a lot.
Do you think that after you hang up your rugby boots, you might go back to playing netball for a club or something?
Yeah, definitely. I do miss it. Like, I miss the sport itself, and I just miss being able to do like loads of random sports. Like, I've always been quite sporty growing up, so I definitely turn my hand to different things when I finish.
Your grandpa was a seriously good player, and it sounds like he was a major part of your development.
Yeah, definitely. So he played for Cinderford back in the day. I think he almost got called up to Gloucester, but he didn't actually know that the scouts were after him, so he never really got told that, which is the story that he says. But yeah, he's played like all across the back line. From what I've been told, I never saw him play, obviously, but very skillful guy. He always gets a bit of stick when I do interviews saying that he was great and stuff, but I'm pretty sure that that is true. He basically used to take me to the local club, like Cinderford Bridge. We used to kick on this pitch. He used to teach me how to kick. Like, we'd look at passing and stuff like that. And like, just my whole family, like, they're so supportive. But he's definitely one that taught me growing up.
How often does he come and watch you play?
As much as he can. So obviously moving back home, so family are from Forest of Dean and I play at Gloucester Hartbury now. So it helps that I'm so close. Like, he'll get to the pitch. He doesn't move as well as he used to, but he'll get there whenever he can. And same with mum and dad. Like, they're literally at pretty much every game I play, which is amazing. So.
Is it true that always present at your matches, perhaps less interested in the rugby, was your grandmother, or is your grandmother who put her time to good use in other ways?
Yeah, so she loves to knit. Like, she's got arthritis in her hand, so she knits a lot, like, to keep that at bay. But she'll come to the games, and she doesn't get it as much as obviously granddad and dad are really into it. Mum loves it. She's so much more knowledgeable now than she was. But yeah, Gran doesn't get it as much, but she'll just sit there like she can knit without looking. So she'll just be knitting away as the game's going on.
Do you think that's a stress thing? You know, her granddaughter's out on the field getting beaten up
by
all these other players.
No, she loves it. She loves it. Like, yeah, grandma's class. So she absolutely loves it. Like, they just love the sports, and they love all the girls. Like, I think we played Loughborough the other week, and granddad was there, and he hadn't seen people like Katie or Skaz or Sunt or any of those in ages, because he didn't make any of the autumn internationals, and he was just buzzing to see all of the girls and like give them a big hug and stuff. And like, all the girls are the same, like, with my family, like, they love them. So
that's
really
lovely.
Nice. Yeah,
and opportunities like that, I suppose, also allow your grandmother to distribute the bobble hats and the jumpers. Yeah, and the skulls.
She doesn't do those anymore, but they're kind of on demand now. So after a few of the girls have had like the cardigans or the jumpers, they're now getting more and more requests in, so we'll see.
Amazing. It's such a family effort. Although actually, thinking about it, your sister's contribution, if it's giving you cake, because I understand that your sister is a baker, as an elite athlete, that can't be a good thing.
Oh no, it was epic. So bless her for my 50th cap in the autumn, the game against Italy. She came into the change room, which was actually like real special for her to see what it's about for us.
Yeah.
Like, post game, obviously good result for us, and she baked us like these 2 cakes that one said 5 and one said 0, and the girls absolutely loved them. Like, they were lapping it up. So I think when you work that hard, it's okay to have a little treat at the end of it.
100%, especially on an occasion like 50 caps.
Yeah.
So exciting. Now, I'm asking some of the younger players to tell me what their Wikipedia pages would say were they to be written. But you've already got one, and it is a doozy. So I'm just going to run a few lines from your Wikipedia page by you. She is often associated with her sky blue hair scrunchie, where her teammates often call her Mrs. Bobble. In an interview, she claims that she gained inspiration to play rugby in a dream, where she saw her best friend Emily lifting Bruce Forsyth in a line-out, and many of her fans have described her as fit and a top bird. Can you confirm or deny any of the above?
So this actually happened after a night out. So I met one of Millie Wood's best mates, Emily Andrews, who is the Emily that's referred to in this. And she went home and she changed mine and Skaz's pages. And basically, this is the stuff she wrote about me, like just joking around. And Skaz's got changed back, so it said that like Skaz was Emily Andrews' best friend and all of this sort of stuff, and it got changed straight away. So I don't know who's verifying that, but obviously mine stayed, and I literally love it. I've been asked in an interview before, the girls don't call me Mrs. Bobble. Like, I do wear scrunchies quite a bit.
Yeah, what's with the scrunchies? I never see you without one. I think this might be the first time I've ever seen you without one.
Basically, when I was playing sevens before, the girls in the sevens, obviously a little bit younger, and they came in and were loving the scrunchies, and I started wearing them, and the older girls that were back, like I say older girls, like my kind of era that were back still playing 15, so Marley Packer, Katie Daly McLean, obviously Sarah Hunter, they were giving me so much abuse about the fact that I'm too old to wear them, I shouldn't be. And I thought that they knocked a few years off me, so then because people were telling me I shouldn't, I just rolled with it. And now, like, I actually do love them, so...
Yeah, say girls my age and of my era, you're talking like you're geriatric.
No, but you know, it's like we've got quite a lot of youngsters coming through now, which is awesome. But there are like a few, there's some girls that we've been playing with since 2011, like since we've been capped. So there is that definitely a vibe of like with the older girls that, not necessarily older, but just more experienced, I guess.
So no Bruce Forsyth.
No, unfortunately not, but I stand by it. I think it's brilliant. And I've been to a few different events where people have literally, what they do to research, they just go on your Wikipedia, don't they? So they're like, I've been asked like in a really serious, like all dressed up in this Q&A, asked about this sort of stuff, and I cannot stop laughing because I just think it's brilliant. But so if anyone else wants to add anything in, then carry on.
You actually just opened that up to the whole...
100%, go for it, let's see.
A big swirly autograph, whatever you like, don't worry about the lines. You're a maverick, you don't need those.
I'm Mo Hunt, England Red Rose number 165, and this is Getting to Know the Red Roses.